we were always leaders in shoulder surgery, starting with Harrison McLaughlin in 1935. Then he was joined by Dr. Neer in around 1950. Neer decided to start his own shoulder fellowship in 1977. And from that, we've gone on to do significant research and contributions to both shoulder and elbow surgery. And that's been carried on by Bill Levine and Chris Ahmad and Charlie Jobin.
The mission of the Columbia Shoulder and Elbow Fellowship has always been to train the next generation of leaders in shoulder and elbow surgery. And that goes back to the days of Dr. Charles Neer, followed by Dr. Louis Biliani, and now by myself. And the faculty here at Columbia are really dedicated to the success of our fellows. During the year that they're here and training, and then well beyond the year in training, as they embark upon their careers in shoulder and elbow surgery, whether they go into academics, private practice, our commitment is to train the next generation of leaders in shoulder and elbow surgery.
Our commitment to education stands apart from every other fellowship, and it begins with the leadership of Dr. William Levine and his commitment to education brings us to new levels where we educate in the operating room and outside the operating room, in conferences and with the latest technology in surgical education.
What makes us unique is our excellence of patient care, our research in shoulder and elbow surgery, and our commitment to mentorship. The mentorship and the ability to get your next job or your first job straight out of fellowship is the strongest here at Columbia. We have a track record of placing our fellows at the best spots in the country.
The experience in my fellowship has shaped my practice in so many ways. The predominant differentiator that I got in my fellowship that I took into my practice was the idea of leadership outside the operating room. We learned how to operate in residency and certainly polish that off in fellowship, but they did have an emphasis on building you as a leader. From a research standpoint, I learned a lot about all facets of research. I learned how to formulate a question and how to stay on top of multiple projects while never losing sight of what the goals are.
The best part of that fellowship is the mentorship that you get. It starts from the minute you match, you get included and invited to the Columbia events at the Academy and at the shoulder and elbow meetings, and it becomes a very tight network of people. These are people that will be your lifelong champions.
Starting practice for me was very comfortable. I felt very confident in my ability to accurately diagnose, evaluate, and manage my patients. Becoming a team physician as a shoulder and elbow fellowship trained surgeon is a little bit unusual. But at the same time, the Columbia Shoulder Fellowship provided ample opportunities for sporting coverage, ample opportunities for training room coverage, and ample opportunities for in-game coverage of sporting events. And in my first year of practice, I felt very comfortable in taking care of athletes at all of these stages.
I work in the sports medicine division at the University of Miami, so it's an academic practice. And I also work half of my week at the Miami VA. So I have two very different styles of medicine that I am engaged in all throughout the week. And my training at Columbia specifically helped me in this team provide some really complex shoulder and elbow care. The fact that I had general sports training from Columbia really got my foot in the door. And then just by chance, the other people that were hired around me made it so that I was able to hone even more into the stuff that I really like.
The Vanderbilt Clinic is one of the outpatient clinics associated with Columbia University Presbyterian Hospital. While you were there, you take care of patients who have shoulder and elbow problems, and it's a weekly clinic, and you have the opportunity to figure out who is indicated for surgery and what surgery they need, and then there's progressive autonomy and experience with that as well. By the end of the year, having done hundreds of these cases, I feel confident to do these cases on my own. It's really a tremendous learning opportunity. And as a new surgeon, just a few months in my practice, you know, that was certainly something that I had in my belt, in my quiver, that experience. And it gave me confidence that had that experience already taking care of patients on my own.
One of the key features that helps to differentiate the Columbia Shoulder and Elbow Fellowship is the notion that this is not a one and done fellowship. This is the start of our relationship with you for the rest of your career. Biennial alumni meetings, the academy meeting, consultation for difficult cases. Our phones are always on. We're always available. And it's really the start of a relationship, both personally and professionally, that becomes extremely profound in your future career as a shoulder and elbow surgeon.